Hola, bienvenidos a Advantage. I'm Fabio. Today we are going to explore the world of verbs. In Spanish, verbs are differentiated according to their ending and their conjugation. We have verbs that follow a pattern. We call them regular verbs. Certain verbs change only the stem of the verb, and we call them stem-changing verbs. And finally, we have verbs that follow no particular pattern. We call them irregular verbs. So today we're going to start the study of regular verbs. Verbs in Spanish are classified according to the ending. There are three types of verbs: AR, ER, and IR verbs. Let's focus on the first group and let's study verbs that end in AR. They are called regular AR verbs. Let's take a look. First, let's review the pronouns. You remember the singular pronouns in Spanish: yo, tú, él, ella, usted. Those are the singular ones. Let's take a look at the plural ones. Nosotros, vosotros. Notice that vosotros is only used in Spain, in the Iberian Peninsula. In Latin America, we prefer to use ustedes as the plural, as well as ellos and ellas. Let's take a look at the verbs. Every verb in Spanish has, of course, two parts, the stem and the ending. In this case, the ending is R and the stem looks like this. For example, hablar. If you take a look at the verb, H-A-B-L will be the stem and A-R will be the ending. So when you look at a verb in Spanish ending in R, you are going to consider everything before the R as the stem. Take a look at more verbs, like mirar. Mirar, you take off the A-R and then that will be the stem. Pay close attention to this AR ending, because that's the part that you are going to remove and you are going to substitute it with the endings. Let's take a look at what endings you are going to be using in Spanish for these verbs. For yo, you are going to remove the AR and you are going to put o. Tú, as. Él, ella, o usted, you're going to use a. For nosotros, amos. Vosotros, ais, with an accent. And for ellos, ellas, and ustedes, we are going to use an. Let's practice. Let's take a look at some verbs. The verb hablar is to speak in Spanish. The stem is habl, of course, hablar, and we are going to use like this. Repeat after me. Hablo, hablas, habla, hablamos, habláis, hablan. Let's take a look at more verbs. Estudiar is to study. Estudio, estudias, estudia, estudiamos, estudia. More verbs. Let's take a look. Swim. To swim, nadar. Nado, nadas, nada, nadamos, nadáis, nadan. So remember, before we go to more verbs, remember what is the literal translation of this regular conjugation. The present tense in English, the present tense in Spanish could be translated in English in three different ways. For example, if I say yo estudio, you could probably say I study Spanish, but also it means I do study, if you want to make emphasis. Or sometimes it can be used as the progressive form. Yo estoy estudiando, I am studying Spanish. So be very careful because it could be translated in these three different ways. Are you ready for more verbs? Let's take a look. Llorar, caminar, saludar, contestar, mirar, escuchar, visitar, desear, llamar. Notice that you will take the AR of the verb off and then you will substitute it with the endings that we just went through. What is the correct form? Let's take a look. I give you hablar and I'm gonna give you a subject. Could you guess how you conjugate the verb? Let's go. Mi amigo y yo, that's us. The answer, of course, is hablamos. Good job. El estudiante, what do you think will be the conjugation? Good job, habla in this case. What's the correct form for this? Trabajar. Mi padre trabaja, good job. Unos amigos trabajan, excellent. Let's try a few more. Cocinar, tú, good job, cocinas. Ella cocina, excellent. You're doing a great job. Let's continue and you will see how easy this conjugation can be. Bailar. Elena y José. It's a group of two, so we refer them as they. Good job. Bailan. Laura y yo, that's us, nosotros, bailamos. Good job. You're doing a great job. Let's continue practicing. Saltar, which is to jump. Yo, good job, salto. ¿Quién? Salta. Good job. ¿Quién is a very neutral question, so they will refer to someone, one person only. More verbs. Buscar. Vosotros buscáis. Notice the accent. The vosotros form is only used in Spain, but time to time you should get used to if you hear it. Ustedes, the plural that we use in Latin America, is abbreviated with a UDS. So ustedes buscan, correct. Let's try more verbs. Comprar. Mis amigos refers to them. Good job. Compran. Ramón y yo compramos. Good job. Cantar. La clase canta. Los estudiantes cantan. A few more. Preguntar, to ask a question. ¿Quiénes? If you notice, the question is in plural, right? Good job. It should be preguntan. For yo, pregunto. If you notice the pattern, all the yo form always end in O. Tocar. Tocar means not only to touch, but also to play an instrument. So let's take a look. Los profesores de inglés tocan. Usted toca. Now let's try to do the following. I'm going to show you some sentences in English, and you will try to see how you say that in Spanish. Number one, I answer a question in class. Yo contesto una pregunta en clase. Good job. How about number two? She's buying a green book. Correct. Ella compra un libro verde. The next one. They need some new pens. And I'm talking about those girls. So I would say ellas necesitan unos bolígrafos nuevos. In Spanish, bolígrafos could also be used with lapicero or pluma in Mexico. Number four, we work a lot in history class. Good job. The answer is, trabajamos mucho en la clase de historia. There are three pronouns in Spanish that you can just simply omit when you answer. Yo, tú, and nosotros. Why? Because the conjugation itself says what the form of the verb is. You are looking for a black backpack. Tú buscas una mochila negra. Excellent. Let's try the last one. You guys are visiting a new high school today. You guys, remember, is ustedes in Latin America. But I'm going to give you the example for Spain. Vosotros buscáis un colegio nuevo hoy. Excellent. Are you ready for your last one? Let's see. I'm going to give you these sentences, and you're going to try to say that in Spanish. Let's go for the first one. He enters class at 10 a.m. Él entra a la clase de español a las 10 de la mañana. Who's swimming on Saturday? Notice the question is in singular, so we are going to use the third person. Very good. ¿Quién nada el sábado? Elena cries a lot. Let's see. Elena llora mucho. You could also say, ella llora mucho. I do prepare the math homework. Good job. Yo preparo la tarea de matemáticas. We are studying lesson 4. Estudiamos la lección 4. If you notice, nosotros is in parentheses because we can't just simply omit it and go straight with the verb. They dance on Sundays. Ellos bailan los domingos. If you say bailan alone, the person who is listening to you might think that you are referring as ustedes or ellos. So for they, it's very important to do that. Well, with this, we finish our lesson for today on AR verbs. I hope it's clear for you what to do when you encounter a regular verb. Stay tuned for our next video on the second and third group of regular verbs, ER and AR. Muchas gracias. Adiós.